Reversing a list in programming is a very common thing to do. Let's take this list as an example. The list contains numbers ordered from 1 to 10. We want the list to go the other way around, which is from 10 to 1. This is called reversing a list. Reversing a list can be done a couple of ways. Let's start with the reverse method. We simply put in the reverse method at the end of the list we want to reverse. The reverse method changes the actual order of the elements in the list. Now if we print out the list, we can see that the list has become reversed. We can also reverse lists with slicing. List slicing allows us to capture a certain subset of the list. We can do this by adding square brackets and separating the values through colons. Rather than covering the intricacies of slicing in this video, we'll try to keep it simple for the purposes of reversing a list. Normally we have a start, a stop, and a step. If I remove the start, the value before the first colon, it means we'll start at the beginning index of the list. And if I remove the stop, the value after the first colon, it means we should go all the way to the end of our list. This makes sense. We're not trying to exclude certain elements from the list. We just want the elements returned to us in the reverse order. Without the start and the stop, the final remaining value is the step. By using a value of -1, we're indicating that we want to traverse the list by going backwards. Unlike the reverse method, slicing only creates a copy of a reverse list. To store it permanently, you should assign a variable to it, then print it out. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.